I'm Robert Timmons, and you're watching Weekly Words.
Yeah. Stop me. Stop me. Stop me. Once upon a time, the people pleaser in me would hold back. So God said this message is much bigger than rap. It's been happening for years, we've seen it across the map. The boomerang flow, me and Tom just brought it back. Preaching at people with no love. Stay looking at sinners with cold shrugs. The like-minded get met with warm hugs. Welcome to the circus, it's all good on the surface. If you don't agree, then throw a stone. All our house is made out of glass, I'm going home. Thinking, who's who, it's the attack of the clones.
Thank you for tuning in to this week's episode of Weekly Words. I pray that your last week has been truly productive. Last week we talked about embracing your new season and how that required you to walk differently and speak differently and think differently. This week we're going to continue that conversation as I talk about the idea that everyone can't go with you. So let's get started. So far on Weekly Words, every week I've talked about ways to improve your life, right? Ways for you to discover your worth and your self-value, for you to discover your purpose and the calling God has in your life. We talked about how to let go of the distractions and how to plant positive seeds that will grow and blossom and reap harvest in your future and ways for you to reach your goals and to be happy and experience joy and how to keep your faith and all these different things, right? Essentially separating the good from the bad, right? But once you do all those things, you have to realize that everybody can't go where you're going. Everybody has their own destiny, their own path, and their own timeline of how they mature and grow. What's for you is for you. What's for them is for them. And what's for me is for me. So everybody can't go where you are going. And that idea that everybody can't go where you're going is kind of hard to really digest because it's relatively easy to separate the good from the bad, the positive from the negative, right? But whenever you have somebody or something in your life that isn't bad, that actually is good or is enjoyable, and you realize that they can't go with you or they're not going with you or you have to detach, it's kind of weird because you're thinking, why? Like what bad thing are they adding to my life, or how are they hindering me? And the thing is, it's not necessarily that they're bad, but it's just their capacity is not the same as yours. Their journey is not the same as yours. Their timeline is not the same as yours. And lots of times, I think we as people try to hold on to everybody in our life and have them level up with us and go with us to all the different heights that we go. But honestly, they're just hindering us and weighing us down because they were never meant to go to that place with us, okay? Sometimes we have to continue on without those people around us. Not because they're bad or because they're someone who's going to deter us, right? But there comes a time when we have to fully focus on ourselves and what God has for us in our season and in our purpose and on our path. Jeremiah 29:11, and I believe I shared the scripture with you guys before, says, I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Right? It says, I know the plans I have for you. Right? Not your mom, not your dad, not your brother, not your sister, not your girlfriend, not your boyfriend, not your coworker, for you. Right? Everybody can't go to all the levels that you're going to go and all the places that God's going to send you, right? That does not mean that they're bad. That does not mean that you're not going to see them again. But sometimes we have to separate ourselves from the things that just aren't for the next level in our lives. And it is kind of hard to really digest that, right? But let me give you an example. So I have this best friend who, you know, I've known since second grade. We've gone to school together since second grade, and we've been friends ever since. You know, in going through high school, you know, we got even closer. But when it came time to go to college, we went to two separate universities, two separate colleges, and I went up north. And the only time I was home in Houston really was like over Christmas break, right? And sometimes over the summer. And so our friendship kind of dwindled, and we didn't speak that much, right? Not that there were any kind of hard feelings. It was just we fell off, like happens in a lot of friendships and a lot of relationships. Well, during that five and a half year time that I was away at college and away working up north, I was growing and he was growing. And whenever I moved back down to Houston, back home, we reconnected and restarted our friendship. And it's just different now because we've grown into the men that we're supposed to be, and we're still growing. And some of the things that we're both working towards actually intertwine, and we're able to work together on those things and support each other, right? So when we got to that point of graduating high school and we both had to go on to our next seasons, we had to go different ways. He went right and I went left, right? Not because he was a bad influence or I was a bad influence or whatever the case was. We just had two different journeys to get where God intended for us to go, right? So sometimes that happens in life where the people who have been there supporting us and the people who have been there pouring into our lives or the people who are just around us that we're used to aren't supposed to go to the next place that we're going, right? And we have to have the courage, the wisdom, the knowledge, and the discernment to know when that is so that we're not allowing anybody to hinder the course God has paved for us, right? Everybody cannot go with you every season of your life. Every level that you go to, every chapter that you have, everybody can't be there with you. And that's okay. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper and not to harm. Plans to give you hope and a future. So I want you guys to recognize that it's relatively easy to, you know, to cut off the negative things and detach yourself from the burdens and all the things that are clearly hindering your walk, your journey, your purpose, right, your life. But it's kind of like this gray area whenever it's somebody that's, you know, been there for us or someone that isn't bad, that's actually good and pouring into our life. But like I said earlier, it's just they got to go left and you got to go right, right? And the thing is that our timelines are different. Right. So maybe while you're leveling up, going into your new place, your next place, they're still growing and maturing and developing. Or maybe it's the reverse. Maybe as they're going into their new place, you're still growing, developing and maturing. Our timelines are different. The way we process experiences and emotions and thoughts, the way that we learn lessons, the way that we apply those lessons, the way that we turn our knowledge into wisdom, it's different from person to person. What's for you is for you, what's for me is for me, and what's for them is for them. Everybody cannot go to all the places that you're going. They can't be with you every step of the way. They can't be with you in every chapter, right? Our capacities to handle different things are different. So the work that God is doing in you, you have to let it blossom and come to pass and become the fulfilled person that you are, knowing that it might not always include the person that's right there next to you. So embrace your journey, embrace your walk, and don't let anything or anybody hinder you or stop you. Hey everybody, it's that time again, question time. So this week I only have one question to ask you, and that is, we're halfway through the year. Where are you on the goals that you set for 2018? We are halfway through the year. Where are you on the goals that you set for 2018? Thank you for tuning in to this week's episode of Weekly Words. I hope you thoroughly enjoyed it. If you have any suggestions for topics for me to talk about in the future, feel free to email me at weeklywordsrt@gmail.com. All right, I'll talk to you later. Have a great week. Stop me, oh, somebody stop me. Stop me, stop me, please, somebody stop me. Stop me, stop me. Somebody stop me, and Lord, if I'm doing it wrong, then please stop.